joy of conducting this group. This is an amazing group of musicians, extreme talent, intellect, curiosity, and we've just had a blast preparing this program for you all. I'd like to thank Dr. Sanfin and Dr. Doyle and also Dr. Morris for all their support and help in getting this program going. And at this time, I'm going to turn it over to the students. They're going to share program notes with you from the stage, and I hope you enjoy the show. So first up is Saren. Hello, everyone, and welcome to the first symphony concert of the 2023-2024 school year. My name is Saren Hawtrey, and I'm a music education major in my senior year here at the University of Puget Sound. Tonight's theme is A Burst of Firsts, where each piece performed has brought its own unique breakthrough in the world of classical music. I'm here to introduce our opening piece, the overture of Glinka's second opera, Ruslan and Ludmila, which debuted in the mid-19th century. While Italian and French opera had already been present in Russia for over a century, Ruslan and Ludmila was one of the first widely influential operas to include a Russian libretto, that's the script, as well as a Russian musical themes, rhythms, and melodies. It also featured the very first appearance of a whole tone scale in Russian music, associated with the opera's villain, the sorcerer Chernomor. Glinka's impact helped to inspire a new era in the Russian classical scene, helping to make the genre more accessible to the people of Russia and creating a model for other Russian composers to reference for generations to come. Thank you.
Thank you. Into Oberlin College on scholarship at the age of 14. He would then graduate from his conservatory with remarkable honors and go on to study at the Curtis Institute for Music and become their first ever black graduate in 1945 at the age of 23. His extensive list of bursts of firsts would only grow more impressive as he went on with his career. Though almost his whole life he worked nonstop creating, composing, and playing music, he was in high demand and received many commissions from work for highly acclaimed systems. It was not until fairly late in his life, in 1996, that he became the first ever black recipient of the Pulitzer Prize, and would continue to receive constant praise and awards past that point, including 6 honorary doctorate degrees, as well as an entry into the American Classical Music Hall of Fame in 2000. George Walker, while being a strong figure in classical and orchestral music, was not bound to a single sound, showing influences from more popular modern music to black spirituals. The piece of George Walker's that we will be playing tonight is his most performed piece, Lyrics for Strings, which he composed at the age of 24 after the death of his grandmother, which he was very close to. His first composed string quartet, Lyrics for Strings, was first titled Lament due to it being dedicated as an elegy to his late grandmother. An idol of hope and darkness, Walker's Lyrics for Strings has been used often since its release, but most recently been used in conjunction with pieces like Amazing Grace and Lift Every Voice and Sing for vigils held to honor the lives of those lost to police brutality and systematic racism. I hope you enjoy.
Thank you. everybody. Thank you so much for coming out tonight. I always love seeing everybody's faces. My name's Jackson. I'm a violinist. I'm a sophomore, and I'm a music education major here at the University of Puget Sound. So this is the concert of firsts, and what better way to end it than with Beethoven's First Symphony. Just a little history on Beethoven. He was 30 years old when he composed this and was an up-and-coming composer in Vienna. You could say he was the influencer of his time. He was following the traditions of Mozart and Haydn, Haydn being one of his teachers. And the crowd loved Mozart. They wanted more Mozart and Haydn. It's like when Maze Runner and Divergent and Hunger Games all came out at the same time. We all loved it. We didn't need more, but we wanted more, right? It was like that. But Beethoven had a slightly different idea. He fits in with most of the classical expectations throughout most of the piece, but introduces himself. He conforms to most of the classical expectations within the first, second, and fourth movement, but then surprises the audience with his vivacious tempo in the third movement. He likes to play tricks on the audience with his manipulation of keys, his choices of phrasing, and his use of the winds. I hope this piece excites you as much as it excites me as I play with my peers. Thank you very much for coming. Please enjoy.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.